all the way from Ghana to be with us. Have I introduced everybody else? Everybody, good. Then we also have, yes, we also have the regional deacon here, Elder Albert Boabe, executive member, and then Elder.
Amen.
All right, then we have Apostle S.Y. Finch, all the way. He's the representative of the Church of Ghana Pentecostal Council. God bless you for coming.
We are the world.
side offering. Amen. We shall hear our first reading from the Epistle to Thessalonians, chapter 2. I'm reading the first 16 verses. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 1 to 16. I'm reading from the New King James Version. Let's hear the word of God. Paul's ministry in Thessalonica. You know, brothers and sisters, that our visit to you was not without results. We have previously suffered and been treated outrageously in Philippi, as you know. But with the help of our God, we dare to tell you his gospel in the face of strong opposition. For the appeal we make does not spring from error or impure motives, nor are we trying to trick you. On the contrary, we speak as those approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel. We are not trying to please people, but God, who tests our heart. You know, we never use fraudly, nor do we put on a mask to cover our greed. God is our witness. We were not looking for praise from people, not from you or from anyone else. Even though as apostles of Christ, we could have asserted our authority. Instead, we were like young children among you. Just as a nursing mother cared for her children, so we cared for you because we loved you so much. We were delighted to share with you not only the gospel of God, but our lives as well. Surely, you remember, brothers and sisters, our toil and hardship. We worked night and day in order not to be a burden to anyone while we preach the gospel of God to you. You are witnesses, and so is God, of how holy, righteous, and blameless we were among you who believe. For you know that we dealt with each of you as a father deals with his own children, encouraging, comforting, and urging you to live life worthy of God who calls you into his kingdom and glory. And we also thank God continually, because when you received the word of God which you heard from us, you accepted it not as a human word, but as it actually is, the word of God, which is indeed at work in you who believe. For you, brothers and sisters, became imitators of God's churches in Judea, which are in Christ Jesus. You suffered from your own people the same thing those churches suffered from the Jews, who killed the Lord Jesus and the prophet and also drove us out. They displeased God and are hostile to everyone in their effort to keep us from speaking to the Gentiles so that they may be saved. In this way, they also heap up their sins to the limit. The wrath of God has come upon them at last. This is the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, King Kai. I will pop mark a big kind out, shock or mark to Salonica for 18 years. A chicken back who could see doing sia. A tea seminal or say, as soon as for no asenka out to Salonica. Now, Eliano, more Aramuni said, Yan quite are in Yaba Momono and Yapa. Then Momuni said, Yehu Amalekai. Na waboye adapa ewo Filipo no. Yeye nam, yeye nkupon asenke mo. Yeye nkupon asenpa mo chere mo. Oku bebre mo. Na yeye efutu sem, no infi nanda ana ifimo. Na anso enam, enam isisimo. Na nemo, senya o nkupon ebuse, ye fatase ode asenpa mo sheye nsamo. Sa alonso ena ye kasa. Enye se wo a wo so nipa eni. Nemu nyankopo a oso ye nkomade no eni. Na yanka adabedefen sem da sene amunim no enso yanfa ensem anye enibre kataso onyankopon ne dansefo enso yanhwehwe nipa enim enonyam enfimo ana obiara nchan anka yewo ho kwan se yeye yeho akase se kristo asomafo nanso yeye yeho brebre ewo mu sene obajijefo bi je na kasa memba na se yepe mo asem yiye se nti enye onyankopon asem nunko na yepe se yane mo che na mo ye akasa kra nso ifi se mayeye adofo hallelujah
amen
na enyanom mo kaye modembo ejuma ne obre ifi se yeye ejuma anajo ne ewia na yanye adesoa amma mu biara na yede ka onyankopon asempa no kyerem mone onyankopon ne adasefo senia yeye ye ho kronkron ne
nyansa bua kwenya meno onu no hune chadie oye no ne orinya umumuda nesam namo wa erade erade once and I wonder erade once and I
As we receive the delivery of the word of God from our chairman, Apostle Dr. John Kwame Appiah. Amen. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to his name.
Amen.
Yeah, we want to make sure we leave here on time. Since some people came from far and they have to catch their flights. And that's why today I wanted to spare me with the interpretation.
But don't let your heart be troubled, because my English is not that, the King James type of English. It's not even the New International Version. It is the good news for modern people. Oh, hallelujah. So don't let your heart be troubled. And this morning, I want to share with you a short message I have entitled Opportunity. Opportunity. In this world, where you are now, the level you are now, or the standard you are now, are the result of the seized opportunities or the missed opportunities in your life.
Amen.
Opportunities that came in your life that you were able to grab it, seize it. You did not sit down and let it pass. And because of that, certain blessings have come your way,